With so much content whizzing around out there, there's only one storytelling platform that helps you keep calm and stay informed and inspired. Flipboard. Flipboard curates the world's stories so you can be smarter in your work, life, and play. Choose from thousands of topics to personalize Flipboard and get the latest stories from the best publishers and experts delivered to you 24/7. When you see stories you want to save or share, tap the plus button to add them to private or public collections. It's that simple. Used by millions of people every day, Flipboard is how people move themselves and the world forward. Get started now at Flipboard.com. It's the E-Commerce Minute, your daily dose of e-commerce, tech, and retail news with your hosts, Bart Meraz and John Suter. The E-Commerce Minute is a production of Sumo Heavy, a digital commerce consulting firm in Brooklyn, New York, and Philadelphia. Find us on the web at sumoheavy.com. It's E-Commerce Minute, episode 338.
In today's episode, Alibaba kicks off 10th annual 11/11 Shopping Festival.
Alibaba's Singles Day shopping event is coming up, and the company has already kicked off the festivities. The event is in its 10th year and now a month-long shopping festival, and the company says this will be its biggest ever. Alibaba said its upcoming mega shopping event will be the largest ever in terms of scale and reach, as it looks to continue growing what has become a multi-billion dollar sales day. Current Alibaba CEO Daniel Zhang created the event in 2009. That year, the Singles Day Festival brought in $7.8 million in gross merchandise value. Total GMV generated in 2017 was $25.3 billion with a B. In comparison, online sales for Black Friday in the U.S. racked up $5 billion last year, according to data from Adobe. Daniel Zhang said, "This year marks the 10th anniversary of 11/11. On the back of Chinese explosive digital transformation, the festival's outstanding growth over the past decade has powered the steady rise in quality consumption sought by Chinese shoppers. The evolution also showcases the development of the Alibaba ecosystem over time, expanding well beyond e-commerce." The event attracts a wide range of brands. The company states that over 180,000 brands from China and other countries will take part in the event, up from 140,000 last year. 200,000 smart stores featuring categories like apparel, home decor, and consumer goods will help boost traffic to online and offline shopping destinations, according to the company. The festival will also cross into other countries, with Philippine e-commerce company Lazada holding an 11/11 shopping festival for the first time across the Philippines, Vietnam, Singapore, Malaysia, Thailand, and Indonesia. The festival will also feature local businesses and services. Kobai, a life search engine that is a sub-organization of Alibaba, aims to draw in users through half-price discounts on offerings such as karaoke bars and hair salons. And let's not forget grocery. Alibaba's Hema supermarket will designate 11/11 signature stores featuring a number of promotions. The company also plans to have a See Now, Buy Now fashion show from the Tmall collection broadcast on multiple platforms to give customers the opportunity to buy their favorite items on the spot. 11/11. Big, big, big.
So 11/11, huh?
Yeah, it's back again. It feels like just yesterday we were talking about this.
Yeah, it would be interesting next year when it's 11/11. 11th anniversary of 11/11.
Ah, I see what you did there.
I see. Right. So 10th anniversary. How big do you think it's going to be?
Well, last year was $25 billion, but what they've done is, they're not cheating, but they keep expanding it. So it's hard to compare apples to apples, but I would say they're going to go past $35 billion. That's going to be my...
That's going to be big.
It's going to be huge, but they have, they're just making it bigger and bigger. So again, it's hard to make a even comparison, but it's really admirable what they've done is they've taken just kind of a made up holiday and made it this mega multi-billion dollar sales day. It's really staggering to think about how much money is being made in just one day.
Yeah. And right before holidays, like that's crazy, right?
Yeah. So the only comparison that we have obviously is Black Friday. And that's like a measly $5 billion.
Right. Cause it's supposed to be the big one, or that whole weekend's supposed to be big. And for them, just one day is just trounce everything. Thing, right? It turns the whole holiday season for US, right?
The whole season. I mean, it's just really incredible. So American companies have tried to copycat this. Amazon, obviously, with their Prime Day. They started that in 2015. Amazon, I know they're not really fast and loose with their numbers, but the number was $4.2 billion, which is big. It's huge. I mean, that's bigger than all of the Black Friday sales, isn't it? And that was up 33% from the year before. And I think other retailers are trying that. Like Wayfair has that Way Day. I know. Did you do your Way Day shopping? I forgot to get my Way Day tree and my.
I did not do my
put up my Way Day lights. And I think it's kind of American shoppers are conditioned, so I think it would take a lot to nudge or create some kind of fake shopping day. I mean, besides with Prime Day, because there's a lot of good stuff on Prime Day, but it's not. There's no reason for it. Like there's nothing special about it except Amazon is having a sale, and that's really there's nothing big about it.
And that's it. It's nuts how much they go through, right?
It's amazing. So let's talk stats because we love to talk stats. Last year, digital was huge for Alibaba. A whopping 90% of the total gross merchandise volume for the 24-hour shopping event was settled through Ant Financial's Alipay, which is owned by Alibaba. And that is up 82% from 2016. So Chinese consumers have embraced digital. And we said that's because once they, quote unquote, came online, they're digital natives. They're not like, they didn't have to switch from one thing to another. It was like all of a sudden, you know, digital is just more of a natural thing for Chinese consumers. So that's kind of not surprising. So to compare, let's see what they have to go against this year. Last year was 140,000 brands. This year it's 180,000 brands. Last year was 15 million products listed. Last year they managed 812 million orders, 1.48 billion payments processed. And as we said, 25.3 billion in sales within 24 hours. So compare it to 2016. So that's 2017's number. 2016 was 17.8. So that's up almost 10 billion. So if I say my 35 billion, that might even be conservative.
Yeah, that could be. Insane. I mean, would they hit 40?
I mean, that's
nuts, right?
You're going to write this down. I'm going to
write that down. Be 40. I guess we'll find out on the 12, huh?
Yeah, 40 billion. Okay. Hopefully. We're making a note here. Live note taking. Right. And you know, I love my stats. So what is interesting is there was a certain number of merchants that really knocked it out of the park. This is 2017. 167 merchants generated $15 million in sales each. That's just on one day. 17 merchants surpassed $75.4 million each. 6 merchants made $150.9 million each on Singles Day last year. So this is a big deal. The big money.
It's big.
All right. So we'll check back, obviously, after the numbers come in. It's, you know, there's a lot of hoopla, a lot of advertising. They're even launching a satellite. We might do a separate story on that. Who knows? They do all kinds of crazy stuff. So real, real big deal over in China. Got anything else to add, Bart?
I think we're good. I guess we're going to have to see how it goes on 12, right?
Yeah. I think the numbers, I mean, I don't know if it takes a day or two, but we'll definitely report back on that. Full show notes are at ecommerceminute.co. That's your e-commerce minute for today. We'll see you on the internet tomorrow. That's it for today's show. If you like the show, do us a favor and subscribe or leave us a review on iTunes. And don't forget, you can now listen to the e-commerce minute on your Amazon device. Just add e-commerce minute to your flash briefing. And finally, if you have a comment or suggestion, or just want to say hi, find us on social media at Sumo Heavy.